This question asks you to implement a cache, and to show you why we might need a cache, I'm going to run the code without one, but for 40 instead of 100. So let's see how long it takes. So while that's running, we'll look at the code to execute the cache. What the format of the cache will be, which is a dictionary, is as its key values, it will have the inputs and the value will associated with that key will be the output. So it'll be an input-output pair. We don't want to evaluate the code more than once for any given input. So what we're going to do is check whether the input is in the cache or not. If it isn't in the cache, we'll add it to the cache. So we're now ready to return it. So for the input, we return the value of the cache. If it's not in there, we add it. If it is in there, we just return it. And let's see if that runs. And it does fairly quickly. So now let's go back to the uncached version and see how that runs for just an input value of 40.
And now we have our solution. The answer to the 40th Fibonacci number, and that's what this calculates, cache Fibo is actually Fibonacci numbers, and you'll learn more about those in Unit 6. First number's the answer, and the second number is the amount of time it took in seconds to calculate that number. So that's without the cache. Now let's have a look at the cache, at the same version with the cache, and I'll run that. And you can see that it's done in about 0.1 milliseconds. So there's a huge difference there, 2 minutes or 0.1 milliseconds.